Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. Today I am teaching a class at NABTA, which is Nail and Beauty Training Academy, which is actually in Stirling in Scotland. It's not raining too bad today, fingers crossed. So what I'm going to show you today is we're going to do some marbling, some 3D encapsulation, some glass work. It's going to be amazing. Let's get cracking. I've already applied the tip. Super easy to do. We have plenty of tutorials showing you how to do that. I've dehydrated the nail, first of all. Then we are going to use the Ultra Bond Acid Primer. Tap off your excess. You don't need a lot of it. And just draw it down and watch it disperse over the nail. So, if we look at the powders, and this is how you judge how pigmented your powder is. If the powder is super pigmented, then you won't get great structure, but you'll get fantastic colour. So if we look at these powders and we sort of move them around, you see how this gathers on itself?
It's like talcum powder.
Chalkiness.
Yeah, that's super pigmented. Takes a while to settle flat, so you'll get more colour than structure with that.
Stop snapping, please.
Same with this one, you see how this really gathers on itself, so it's really pigmented. Sometimes they can...
Just while you're talking.
Sometimes they, when they're super pigmented like that, they can marble a little bit because they are so pigmented. But don't worry about that, you just need to work the powder. And then you see the blue, look at that, that just falls like sand. So that's really good for structure. It's going to have good pigment, but not like super intense, so you couldn't like paint with this. Because you can paint with acrylic powders. So we did that little explanation for your pigments in your powders, because if something's super pigmented and you put it straight onto the nail, it won't adhere quite as good. So I am going to lay down a very thin layer of clear, and that'll just eradicate that problem. So if you ever think, oh, I'm not too sure, just put that little tiny bead, quite wet. Get rid of that bit of glitter. Wanting to join the party. So you want this as thin as like a top coat. So as if you've just top coated the nail. And then you sort of, it's like a little comfort blanket. You know that everything will adhere. And then when I marble, I like to use clear. This, I think clear is the magic ingredient. So we're gonna pour a bit of this. Clear. A little bit of this purple. And a little bit of clear. And a little bit of white. And a little bit of clear. Gotta work quick. And a bit of that color. Oh, that's a bit nice. And a bit of that, and a bit of that. And then we're gonna shape the brush like a blade, pull it through, get your cuticle nice. I'm gonna pull this up here a bit because we need a bit of product there. It's kind of created a nice little swirl. The clear will make your marble look cleaner. So what the clear does, it's kind of like when you do a gel polish marble, if you add clear into it, have you ever done that?
Mm-hmm.
And it crisps the lines.
Yep.
Yeah, so it sort of pushes against the color and makes the lines crisper, so they don't sort of like merge like that. So it's kind of cool. And you get some little transparent bits, and it kind of adds a little bit of depth as well, like granite. So it's really nice. I want to leave this section a little bit empty. I'm going to put a tiny bit of this here, just to get a bit closer to the cuticle and also sort of get rid of that solid pink, because you want it to flow. You don't want it to have this bang, this big pink bit, and then you've got all these beautiful swirls. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So, I don't know if you can pick this up. Can you see how you've got this depth?
Mm-hmm.
Let me wet it, see if you can see a bit more. So you can see how it dips down. And you get that sort of granite kind of depth to it. It's the clear that's doing that. So it is super important to separate your colours with a little bit of clear. Even if it's, you know, it's a smaller bead than your bead of colour, it will still help when you do that marbling. I am now going to get some high speed into a little dampened dish. And move him out the way. If we were using medium speed before, now we're going into high speed because we're going to do some 3D encapsulating. Now you need a tiny, tiny, tiny 3D brush for this. And you see how high I'm going into the powder. What does that mean, girls, when I'm going high?
That's morbid.
Yes, loving it. I'm going to pop that down, clean my brush, tickle this out into a croissant shape or a half moon. I just like the word croissant more than the half moon.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
You're so boys. You're such boys. A boomerang.
Yep. Boomerang.
And then the point of the brush is towards the centre, and that will have the most pressure on that.
Just your big hand in the way.
Oh, sorry. So the point is towards the centre, and as I press, it will move outwards. This is super important to remember. Where you put that bead, it's going to move back. So you need to plan that when you're doing your flowers, yeah? So we want it to be nice and thin. Thinnest part will be towards the centre. I'm going to get another bead and just sort of tickle that out into your little croissant shape. That definitely looks like a croissant.
That one,
yeah.
Looks, yeah.
That's a croissant.
Looks like a teddy bear head, actually. No, for this.
A what?
A teddy bear's head.
Oh, yeah. Does, yeah. There are the ears. There's a face.
Oh, right.
You remember it however you want to remember it, because then at least you'll actually take it in. So I love remembering things by them looking like something. So look, see how close I went? And then as I press it, it moves back. Yeah?
Yep.
So I've got a nice crisp outside edge, and the middle gets a little bit more faded. So again, we've gone right in the middle, and then you see now they're overlapping. So each one is overlapping at least a quarter to half. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. So you've got one here, and then you've got one there. So they're overlapping at least a quarter, sometimes a half, yeah? And I'm going to get a little bead, and it's going to be more like a little sperm. Or tadpole. Or comet. So we have this little comet, and we're just going to tease this out. And then look how high my brush is now. And I'm going to press this from the center out. Going to do another one here. But I'll show you the leaf first. Bead into the bead, pull out, and then a little bit in. See that shape? That's what we're looking for. You can knitting it up slightly. So working with high speed, you see how I can just start to work this straight away. I'm going in and out, pressing out from the centre to open that leaf. Then you can either use a spatula or a craft knife to just pull and press these little sort of vines. So we're going to do another flower here. Don't forget this is going to move back. If I was doing this sculpted, I would lay down a clear layer first. So I had something to work onto whilst I'm working onto a foam, and then the flowers could just peel off. Yeah? I want them to stick, and this will stick to the tip. But if we were doing it as a sculpt, it would stick to the clear acrylic. Okay, so now I'm gonna get this medium speed. And we're going to take a bit of Devil's Shadow. And we're going to mix that in to our liquid.
Is that just a gel polish?
Gel polish. It's a true gel. It's not a hybrid gel. It won't work with a hybrid gel. It needs to be a true gel. You know if it's a gem. Well, you know, the rule sort of is, if you know if it's a hybrid because it smells like nail varnish. Mm-hmm. So a little bit more. Mix it in. This isn't something you can save because it will separate. So what we're going to do now, we're going to do this thinly, clear, straight onto your flowers.
Look at that.
Look at what happens.
Love it.
Oh, it adds. It adds all the shade.
Do you know, funnily, the past couple of weeks I've been doing 3D art and it's like, it comes and goes.
Yeah. It definitely, I think, depends how you feel about it as well. And you kind of have little fads. I have little fads of doing the same kind of thing because you just enjoy it.
Well, there's, I had stuff that popped up and it was the tie-dye marble. Mm. See, that's what we're doing for Ibiza Fashion Week, right? And then you had posted it. I was like, it's coming back around. And I done it years ago and then it's like fashion. It comes back around again.
It does, yeah. It really does.
I really like that.
It's amazing.
So you see how it adds shadow. Do you know when you were saying, can you use different colours? And I was like, wow.
No point.
No point, is there?
So what other colours are quite good for this other than the red?
Like a navy. Black looks really good as well because you get like a grey shadow.
Portion, perfect.
So we've done like skull. I made a 3D skull in white and put the grey. Mixed the black, it's like a grey and give it all the shadows. That was really cool. So you can really, and you could do like a full nail of 3D and do lots of different colours. So it was like that glass kind of effect over the flowers. That would look lovely.
I'm so excited.
So you can just really play about with it. So, you know, now's the time to play about with it. Because if you make any mistakes, I'm here to help you. So if you want to try something out, try it out today. If you've got an idea, you think, oh, actually, what about this? Try it out today. So now I'm going to make sure I encapsulate now, and I'm going to put a little bit of clear on. I only needed a little bit of this, that, you know, that colour that we've mixed. I didn't need to put too much on. I didn't need to build with it. All I was doing was adding colour over the top of the flowers. So this layer of clear will now give you your structure. So I'm chest pinching, and I'm like, are we squishing a bit too much? Is it moving? Does it feel like rubber still? You know what I mean? And it feels a bit spongy. We don't want it to be like that. Now we can come on. Those few seconds made a big difference. And we can pop that tool on now. And then we can pinch through the length, which we won't have to do a lot because it's quite a pinch tip. Just gonna pinch a little tiny bit more.
My sister does nails as well, and I sent her the pictures of my nails yesterday, and she was like, oh my goodness, like the difference between an unpinched nail and a pinched nail is like night and day.
I'm definitely gonna start pinching. But it, like I say, it's only gonna add about 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Because you just pinch it, and then you're well away doing the other one, aren't you?
Yeah.
It's just getting into the routine of then taking that off and then.
Yeah,
you only maybe one or two pinches, that's all you need. You get away with one for salon.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna do my normal filing routine. coming up the side walls first, keeping that side nice and straight. The file is straight with the finger. We're not angling it up. And then we're going to whip round the cuticle area. I'm going to go to a softer file because I think you may cut a little bit easy. And then we're going to contour. And remember, we break down the file and you're going to do these sides first like this. Coming up at this angle.
That's what I was going to ask you yesterday. So see when you go up the sides like that and then you come down the top, do you leave like a, almost like a tiny little point that you then go over and take off?
Yeah, because if you look at that, I haven't gone into that bit ever. I want to get these sides the right thickness. And I'm keep checking underneath, have I got enough room to file? And then I'm looking at the flowers, have I got enough room to file? Yeah? Mm-hmm. And then I'll be like, right, I need to sort the apex and the top out, and I just sort of marry them together. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Mm-hmm. And I'm pulling to the tip.
When you're failing like that as well, you're kind of pushing the acrylic back.
So, and I'm looking down the barrel of the nail as well, checking everything. Let me just turn your hand over a sec.
Oh, putting
underneath as well. I know, it's nice underneath there.
Yeah, it looks nice and too underneath. And I really can still file a little bit here and here. Not so much there, but this one is a little bit thicker. So, that's this side.
Juicy berries.
Mm-hmm. Is everyone dying to have a go now?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'll tell you what we'll do. I'll buff this now, put a few stones on, you can get cracking. Then I'm going to wipe over with gel residue, wipe off solution. That's so pretty.
Peeking through a little bit, isn't it? Just enough.
Yeah. Nice. There. And a little bit there. Mm-hmm. Just like highlights it a little bit. So I was saying, don't worry too much if that happens because it looks kind of cool. So I'm just going to finish off with a little bit of cuticle oil. Rub that in. And ta-da! There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today will be listed below, as always. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. So, when we're thinking about we're going to... Oh, shut the with the cuffs. Sorry.
It's coming downstairs.
Getting to know you, getting to know all about you. Oh, for God's sake, Adam. He likes pushing in. And bottom.